بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. اللهم صل على محمد النبي الأمي وعلى آله وسلم تسليما. Today our topic of discussion is function overloading in object-oriented programming. What is function overloading? If any class have multiple functions with same names but different parameters or arguments, then they are said to be overloaded functions. Functions overloading allows you to use the same name for different functions to perform either same or different tasks in the same class. Function overloading is usually used to enhance the readability of the program. If you have to perform one single operation but with a different number of data or types of argument, then you can simply overload the function. Here you see different ways to overload a function. Now as you have been understand the definition, that concept of the function overloading is you will have two or more functions in the same class with the same name. You can implement this concept of overloading by two different ways. One, by changing number of arguments, and the other one by having different types of arguments. Now first we discuss the changing number of arguments. In this type of function overloading, we define two functions or more functions with the same names but different number of parameters of the same type. Here you see the declaration. The first definition here, sum is the name of the function which takes two arguments of type int, that is x and y, and it adds these two arguments x plus y. Now you can see the second function which is being overloaded. Now the name of this function is also sum, but it takes three arguments of type int, x and y and z, and it is and this function performs the addition of the three variables x, y and z. Now the two functions are being overloaded. Both have the same name, but the difference between these two functions is that first one takes two arguments and the second one takes three arguments. This is how you can implement the function overloading, by changing the number of arguments. The second way is by having different types of arguments. In this type of overloading, we define two or more functions with the same name and same number of parameters, but the type of parameter is different. Now here you can see the first definition, in which the function name is sum. It takes two arguments x and y of type int, and it is the performing the addition of the these two arguments. Now you see the second function which is being overloaded. It also takes two arguments x and y, but the type of the argument is double. So this is also the concept of overloading, by changing the types of arguments. I hope you will understand the concept of overloading a function. Now you test the program using the C++ editor. Okay, now how you can call on overloaded function? When you overload a function, you will pass the values for the parameters. Now here you see you are calling the first sum with the values 10 and 20, and in the second function you are calling sum with the three arguments 10, 20 and 30. So the first one will call the two parameter function, and the second one is called three parameter function. In the right main, you can see the two functions are being called. Both are passed two parameters, but the first one is passed integer values and the second one has been passed float values. So it will perform the addition of integer and the addition of float respectively. Functions with default arguments. Now, what are default arguments? You can declare your functions with the default arguments. When we mention a default value for a parameter while declaring the function, it is said to be as a default argument. In this case, even if we make a call to the function without passing any value for that parameter, the function will take the default value specified. Here in the example, you see that there are two parameters x and y. X is of type int, y is also of type int, but you have declared that we have declared y with the value is some initial value 0. Now y is what? It has been declared a default value. In the second first two function calls will produce, they exact the same result. Now you can see in the main we have been called three times a function sum, first with the one parameter. In the second call we have declared, we have called a function with the two parameters, that is 10 and 0, but in the third call we have also passed two values, but 10 and 10. Okay, now in this in these callings, the third one call is will produce different result because it will take value 10 for x and value 10 for y. Okay, when you use a default argument, you have to follow certain rules. The first one is rule is that only the last argument must be given a default value. You cannot have a default argument followed by a non-default argument. Now in this, the third declaration is incorrect, in which x is 0 and y is declared after the default argument, so this is incorrect. If you use a default argument, then you will have to define all the subsequent arguments. Now in the below example, the second declaration is incorrect because when y becomes a default and it takes a 0, then z must be declared as a default. So the last one declaration is correct. You can give any value to a default value to the argument compatible with its data type. Mean if you declared x as int, then you will give any integer value to x. If you declared x as some other type, then you will pass it. Okay. Function with a placeholder argument. When you declared a function without any identifier, then they are called placeholder arguments. Here are the declarations. Sum is declared with the placeholder arguments. No identifiers are there. Such argument can also be used with the default arguments. Okay, I hope you will understand the lecture. And if you have any problem, you can contact me. And please try to these examples and inform me. Allah Hafiz.